down. So, here you are really showing energetic after Sas talk. It was really enthusiastic talk given by him. And we try to follow all those things. And I'm from CYTER. I'm doing a presentation on Adjuvant Yoga Therapy reduces perceived stress in patients of psoriasis. It's a pilot study. So actually, it's a part of my PhD study. And I want to especially thank my guide, Dr. Amanda sir, and my co-guide, Meena ma'am and Sriram sir. And I want to thank the moderator,
no,
because they give a special opportunity to the King Budding research scholars to present their topics here, so they reach more places. And straight away going into the topic. So, it's mainly the topic related to the psoriasis condition patients. And there's a term which was newly given, psychodermatologic disorder. So it's a condition that involves interaction between mind and the skin. So it has three different types. So psychodermatologic disorder can be categorized into psychophysiologic disorder, primary psychiatric and secondary psychiatric disorder. So mainly the psoriasis fall under the psychophysiologic disorder because it's a direct connection with the emotional status. So the stress play an important role in psoriasis, and it was published by different papers. And what is psoriasis? Psoriasis is an autoimmune disorder without a, it is an autoimmune disorder, and it is genetically determined immune-mediated inflammatory disease. So mediated by T helper cells, T1 and T17 cells. With the prevalence of 0.44 to 2.8% in India, it is commonly affecting individuals in their third or fourth decade. And males being affected two times more common than females. And it was also quoted in some of the research papers. And psoriasis significantly impairs the quality of life of patients and their family, resulting in great physical, emotional, social burden. So here we need to see that psoriasis is not only affect the quality of life, but the stress, once it is caused by themselves and because of them, it has also affect the family members. And so there are other disorders, what sir has mentioned, will affect the people. And for psoriasis, stress is not only the cause, but it has a genetic tendency, food allergies, stress, environment allergies, systematic illness, infections, and skin problems, all in the aberrant immunity problems with linked social psoriasis. And stress, which is the normal cause for most of the conditions, and what is the intensity and duration, and what are the other factors which cause stress, internal factors, injuries, personality, biological age, management of stress, all those things, and the external factors like fetal life, infancy, adolescence age, what are the events they are facing, those type of stress, and lifestyle, and socioeconomic status. All those things put input to them, and how our neural system, endocrine system, and immune system tolerate this. And this, after the leading, this leads to anxiety and depression, and the stress response time. And once we are healthy, we can able to tolerate it. Our homeostasis helps better to tolerate it if we are weak and linked to disease. So the managing stress is the most important one, and yoga proves there are so many research papers published in yoga which helps to manage stress in a better way. And yoga normally increases feeling of wellness, positive attitude, energy level, memory and attention, concentration, social skills, self-acceptance, flexibility and stress. And by practicing yoga, it helps to reduce anxiety, stress, depression and tension, sugar and cholesterol level, increased hemoglobin level, hypothyroidism, weight, cell detoxification, blood sugar, arthritis and tension in the muscles. So yoga is a unique combination of isometric, muscular contraction, stretching exercise, relaxation technique and breathing exercise. So actually the previous instructor sir, Venkateshwaran sir, already said that walking, so only walking will not get a better effect. So by doing yoga, the spinal cord thing is also possible, breathing is also possible, and the various studies show that adjuvant yoga therapy and it's tested in normal subject and also patient with different condition. So, and here the thing is that quit allopathy and join yoga. It's not like that. So it's an adjuvant yoga therapy. So you have to do yoga therapy along with the standard medical treatment, and you can able to feel a better result. And there are so many studies out there coming up nowadays, and my previous presenter Dr. Balaji's studies also having the positive stress scale, and this also is an adjuvant yoga therapy. It's not like the yoga therapy or allopathy. So, and this fact in our study also, it is an adjuvant yoga therapy, and it is a pilot study. We are taking 10 subjects, and here it is a randomized control trial. So we are divided to 5 males and 5 females, and the age category is around 13 plus or minus 30, 8-38 and plus or minus 30. And the study was conducted in the tertiary care hospital, and the patients are referred from the dermatology department, and they have referred the patient and to the CYTER, and CYTER people we give the therapy. So we have the standardized yoga therapy protocol, and it was validated by different professionals in the field of yoga, and those yoga therapy protocol will be given to the psoriasis patients, and they have to attend at least 10 direct sessions, and after that they will be practiced for the next 12 weeks. The pre and post test will be taken. Here we are taking only the one parameter which we call it as Psoriasis stress scale, which was Cohen's scale, who was an inventor, and we recorded before and after 12 weeks of the yoga session. And the Psoriasis stress scale can range the score from 0 to 40. The score which is come 0 to 30 could be considered as the low stress, and its range 14 to 26 considers moderate, and 27 to 40 will be the high Psoriasis stress. There are so many research papers on Psoriasis stress, because I tried to write a review of the review paper on Psoriasis stress, and I get nearly more than 100 papers on Psoriasis stress and yoga itself. And in those papers, let's see if there is a, and there are so many studies on healthy volunteers. On healthy volunteers, we can see the range will be between 13 to 18, and not so only a limited study which is under 13. So the normal subject already have the moderate stress, and the same study was taken in the patients also. And those type of patients, if you take, there's a range is between 27 and above. For example, if we take the previous presenter study itself, the range is above 28 for the pre subjects. And after the yoga subject, it was have a tremendous reduction in that thing. And the methodology part, we have enrolled the patient, assessed for eligibility, inclusion and exclusion criteria. Patient, for the inclusion criteria, we can take the patient with psoriasis on medical management and able to perform the techniques in the protocol. Age limit will be 18 to 65 and willing to participate in the yoga therapy protocol, yoga therapy protocol. And the exclusion will be the patients having the salivary gland tumor, patients having hormone replacement therapies, and the Cushing and Addison syndrome. Already participated in yoga on regular basis, those are the exclusion criteria. The randomization will happen in the dermatology department itself. So they have selected the patient, those who are control or subject. So once they are randomized and they send to the CYTER department, and groups, two groups will be divided, and the group will be giving bi-weekly yoga therapy for 3 months with the standard medical management, and the control group will be standard medical management for 3 months. And after that the pre-test will be taken, which is in this case they have taken the Psoriasis stress scale only. And the 3 months intervention will go, and after that the post test will be done. So these are the techniques we are used for the psoriasis patients, and the Jati's breath body coordination will be given. After that, Talasana. So, Talakriya and Talasana we are normally supposed to give, because this Talasana helps to give more concentration and stability in the person, because those who are affected by stress, they are lacking their confidence level. So, this asana helps to give the confidence level with them. And Trikonasana, the Trikonasana is maybe it's resembles the triangle shape. The triangle shape become correlated with the Manipura chakra. So, this gives the energy. And the Merudasana, we can also have the triangle shape in Merudasana. So, this triangle shape correlates with the energy levels also. And we are giving one more asana like Chatushpada asana, Vyadhu Pranayama. So, we kneel down in the fourth foot. Then, if there is a person with too much stress, they feel the confidence by going into the fourth foot posture and stability. After that, we are doing some Pavanamukta series and Pavanamukta asana, Setu Kriya, and Nadi Shuddhi Pranayama to balance the left and the right energies. Kavi Priya, which is one of the cooling pranayama, Brahmani pranayama, and Kaya Priya, one of the technique we normally followed in our Vedananda tradition, helps to relax the complete body in a relaxed manner. And Spandana Nishpanda technique tense and relax the body muscles, and finally the Shavasana. So this is the set of 13 asana we normally taught to different people, different psoriasis condition people, in a step-by-step manner. So after nearly 5-6 sessions, they have understood all the techniques. Then other 4 sessions, we just see whether they are doing the techniques properly. And then we advise them to practice at home also. And we have the regular checkup by telephonic competition and also the diary maintenance. We just have the regular checkup. And after the period, out of 10, we have given, we asked before, it was 27.8 and after 26.4 in the control group, and it was significantly reduced. And in yoga group, it was 28 point score before and after it was 19. It was more significant compared to the control subjects. Both are psoriasis, but having the standard medical treatment along with yoga, we have the most significant ratio. And we do the between group analysis. So yoga and control before, it was not at all significant, and after yoga and control, it was a significant fall we have seen. The same thing we have presented in a graphical way. So you can see that red line will be the post study, so blue will be the pre. So you can see that in yoga group how fall it was later after the regular yoga sessions. As a result, it was a significant, statistically significant reduction in both groups, and yoga group had more significant 0.01 than the control group. Significant reduction between the control and yoga group performed after the investigation period. And it is concluded that these preliminary findings suggest that yoga may offer a safe and effective intervention for reducing perceived stress in patients with psoriasis. It is more helpful for psychological disorders like psoriasis patients and improve the psycho-neuro-immunoendocrine allergy. And yoga may be considered for positive adjuvant yoga therapy for the experience, for those experiencing this. These are the references. Thank you.
Why there is a reduction in control?
So because we are following the scientific method.
I would like to point out in this study, which is a very interesting study, that actually there are a lot of studies on yoga in different health conditions, but in skin conditions there are not any studies at all. It is a very interesting lacuna that is there in yoga research, that if you go on PubMed, you will find review articles talking about the concept of yoga in skin disorder, but actual studies are not done. So Dayanidhi, his work which he is now doing, is presenting a pilot part of it, is part of his PhD. It is going to be one of the first studies that is actually looking at documentation of the effects. And initially when he said, I have 5 subjects in control, 5 in yoga, I'm like, what are you going to find in 5? Because 5 is a small number. But then when we looked at the finding, every subject is responding. Now that is an amazing finding, that every subject is actually responding, which means that the impact of yoga in people who have psycho-dermatological conditions, it's a new concept, how the mind affects the skin. I think it is something very amazing. And many people may not have realized, Mother Mohan sir asked a very pertinent question, that why the people who are in the control, they were also having a significant change. Now, the change is highly significant in yoga, so we show that addition of yoga is beneficial. And he made a comment, I would like to add to it, that the moment the person was receiving the medical management and they started to improve a bit, their stress levels go down. So a person has a skin disorder, with the treatment, when there is some improvement, the stress will go down a little bit. That is why we found that significance. But when you add yoga, the change is tremendous. So this is what we are trying to bring about, the integration of yoga in the modern medical setting. That yoga is not a competitor to modern medicine. We can be a collaborator. So the word is collaboration, not competition. So I thank Dayanidhi for a very clear presentation.